Hi everyone, in this video we'll discuss two problems, one easy, one medium, of code refs, stacks, linked lists and queues. So let's look at the first problem, the easy one. So the problem says that Rishab has given you a linked list in the form of a head node A. He has also given you an integer B and you need to change the value of each node in the nearest multiple of B, that is less than or equal to the current value. So B should be less than or equal to the current value. And let's look at an example. So let's take this example of 1, 2, and 3. So 1's nearest and b is equal to 2. So 1's nearest multiple of 2 is 0 because 0 into 2 is 0. And 2 into 1 is 2. So 2 is greater than 1. So I'll take 0. And second is the second number is 2. So 2's nearest multiple of 2 is 2. And let's take the third number is 3. So 3's nearest multiple of 2 is 2. So 0, 2, 2 is the answer here. Let's take the second example, 3, 4 and 5. So 3's nearest multiple is 3 itself. So 4's nearest multiple of 3 is 3 again. 5's nearest multiple of 3 is 3 again. Let's look at the explanation part for this one. Let's take an example to understand the code better. Let's say in the linked list A is given like 3, 4, 5, 6 and B is equal to 3. So I need to find the nearest multiple of 3. So 3 into 1 is 3. 3 into 2 is 6. So the nearest multiple, that value that is less than or equal to my current value, I need to find this value. So the nearest value is 3 itself. So 3 will come here. For 4, the near first 4, the value before is 3 and the value after is 6. So I need to take the value that's lesser than 4. So I'll take 3. For 5 again, I can write 5 something like this. So 5 again, the value is 3. For 6, I have value 6. So B of n should be less than or equal to current value. So I can take 6 here. So my answer would look something like this. So now the problem boils down to finding this Bn such that Bn is less than or equal to current value. Now I know this B, I know this current. The only thing I need to find is this N value. So the one way to find this N value is I'll divide both sides by B. So N is less than equal to current by B. So to find the nearest multiple of B, all I now know how to find this N value. So only thing I need to do is multiply B by N. So that is N is equal to current by B. Okay. So what we are doing is we are given a linked list A and we are given the value B. Now we are storing my head inside of an node answer which I'll return at the end, and I'm checking for every node starting from the first node till my current value is null. That means I have reached the end of the node. I'll take this value of that node and then I'll find the nearest multiple of that value, that is this is my N value, and I multiply it by B and I store that value inside of the value of that node, and then I'll just move to the next node. Let's move to the medium question now, the prime calculation. So what the problem states is Robin's mathematics teacher gives him some homework. Given an array A of size N, for each subarray of size B, find the leftmost number with the maximum number of distinct prime factors. And you're asked to return the sum of all such numbers. Since the number can be large, you need to take a 10 to the power 9 plus 7 mod value. Okay, let's take an example. In this example, A is 10, 2, 1, 1 and 2. And B is 3. So window size is 3. So first we have 10, 2, 1. So the maximum number. Maximum number with the maximum number of factors is 10. So we take 10 out. Then the second subarray is 2, 1, 1. So the maximum number with the maximum number of subarrays, the leftmost number with the maximum number of subarrays is 2. So we take 2 out. Then we have 1, 2, 1, 2. So the number with the maximum number of prime factors is 2. We'll take 2 out. And the sum of this is 10 plus 2 plus 2. That is 14. So 14 is the answer. Let's look at the second example now. We have 18, 36, 15 and 210. So the window size is 2. First time we'll have 18 and 36. So 18 and 36 both will have two factors. So the leftmost number with the greatest number of factors is 18. So we'll take 18 out. Next time we'll have 36 and 15. Both of them will again have two factors and the leftmost number is 36. So we'll take 36 out. Then we have 15 and 210. So 15 will have two factors and 210 will have four factors. So maximum number of factors are in 210. So we'll take 210 out. So the answer would be 264. Now let's try to understand this question better. Let's say you are given A as 18, 36, 30 and 210. And your window size is 2. So the first time you will take this window and 18 will have two factors, 36 will have two factors. So the maximum leftmost number with the maximum number of factors is 18. Next time your window reduces to this thing. So you'll remove 18 out and you'll add 30 to it. So this time 30 will have three number of factors. So the maximum is 30. So next time your window moves to this one. So every time you're moving the leftmost out and you're taking one number is added to the previous list, that is 210. Let's say you go with the most brute force way, that is you will create a window every time and every time you'll iterate over through the window and find the leftmost number with the maximum number of factors. So this will take you O of n square time. And that will leave you a TLA since n is 10 raised to the power 6. Let's see if we can do it in a optimal way. Since we are only concerned about the number of prime factors, let's just create an array which contains the number of prime distinct prime factors that number will have. Now what I'll do is I'll keep on increasing my index by 1, and that is I'll keep on moving my window by 1 number every time. So initially I'll have this 2 in my window. So the next window will have this 2 removed and this will be added inside of my window. So every time my left number is getting removed from a window. Now the problem boils down to finding the leftmost maximum number inside of my window. So what we can do to make it optimal is we'll have a queue. In this queue, we'll keep on storing the numbers in the increasing order. So initially we'll have 2 and 2. The next number, once I move the window, we'll have two conditions. Either the value is greater than the previous value or the value is lesser than the previous value. Let's take the first case. That is the value is greater than the previous value. So if the value is greater than the previous value, then will this 2 or this 2 or any value lesser than my current value will ever be my answer? My window is always going to move in the front direction. That is, number is going to be removed from the left side. So this number, that is my current value, which is greater than some number, then this number will be the last to be removed. And if this number is gonna be there for all the numbers lesser than this, then this number will always be the maximum. So this number and this number or any number lesser than this will never be the maximum. So I can remove these two numbers, those numbers that are lesser than the previous value, lesser than the current value. So I'll remove these values and then I'll insert my 3. Similarly, I'll increase my window by 1 and I come at this index. Since 4 is gonna be there for all the windows after this point, then I will definitely have 4 as the maximum and 3 can never be the maximum for the rest of the window. So I'll have 4 here and I'll remove 3 from my queue. The second case is if I have something like the reverse of it. Let's say the reverse of it. So first time I'll have 4 and 3. So should I keep the 2 here or should I not keep the 2? The window is going to be moving, so
at some point these maximum wills be removed from my queue. So this too can somehow have a possibility of my next answer once my window moves ahead. So if the value, current value, is lesser than the last value that I have inserted inside of my queue, I'll keep that value because maybe that value will help in the coming future. Okay. And how will I get my answer? So what I'll do is, whenever I move a window by one, I keep on checking if my first number at the head of my queue, is this index out of my window? If yes, I'll just remove this element and now this becomes my head. I again check if this number is inside of my window. Yes, then this is my answer for this window. I don't have to check for all the numbers. I'll just have to check my head. So what will be the time complexity? Each number is inserted inside of my queue once and each number is removed from my queue once. So the time complexity is O of n. Let's look at the code explanation of this. So what we are using to find the number of prime factors is we are using something like a sieve. So what the sieve do is it starts from 2 and it goes to square root of n, or the maximum value that I have is 10 raised to the power 6. Initially, is prime is 0 for all the numbers. So I'm checking if the current number is prime. If the value is 0, then it is prime. Otherwise, it is not a prime. Then, since every number will have at least one prime factor, so I'll make it 1. Then I'll start from that number and I go till the last number that I can have. And I take all the multiples of the numbers that I've taken, that is I, this number I. So all the multiples of I are taken and I keep on incrementing at that particular position the number of prime factors it has. And if I'm making is prime is equal to 1, then this number is not a prime. Not a prime. So this way I'll get the I'll get the count of number of distinct prime factors for every number, and this will be done only once. I'll calculate the number of prime factors for all the numbers and then I'll never calculate the number. So what I'm doing is, for all the test cases, I'll just calculate the sieve once and then I'll make this TC variable 1. So for all the other test cases, for all the other number of times this solve function is called, I'll never be calculating the sieve again. Okay. Then I'm maintaining something like a dequeue, and what I'm doing is I'm first going through my window of size B. I'm checking if the queue is empty, then I'll insert the prime factors I have. It's a pair of the number of prime factors and what was the value at that particular index, that is A of I and the index. So it's a pair of pair. Else what I'll do is, if the queue is not empty, I'll check last element and check the number of prime factors it has. If the number of prime factors are lesser than my current value, I'll keep on popping it out. And at last, I'll just push my current element inside of it. So this is for the size of window B. Now I'll update my answer and I store that answer inside of my sum variable. So sum variable is nothing but the answer that I'll have. And at the last, I'll just return this answer. Now what I'll do is, I'll start from the bth index, that is after my window, the next element that I want to add, then again I'll do the same thing. Here what I'm checking is, I'm checking if the number is still inside of my window. If not, I'll just remove that element from the start. And then again the same thing, I'll check if the queue is empty, push the element inside of it. If not, then check if the last number is lesser than the current number. Keep on popping and then push the elements inside of it. Update my answer and take the mod value and at last return the answer. Hope this is clear. Thank you.